हरे कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे।
जय श्री कृष्णा चेतन जय श्री कृष्णा चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिव सदि गौर भक्त वृंद। जय श्री कृष्णा चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिव सदि गौर भक्त वृंद। हे कृष्णा करुणा सिंधु दीन बंधो जगतपते गोपेश गोपी कांत राधा कांत नमोस्तुते। तप्त कंचन गोरंगी राधे वृंदानेश्वरी वृषभानु सुते देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रिय। बोलो श्री राधे गोलोकानंद भगवान की जय।
जय
जय
हरे कृष्णा एवरीवन।
हरे कृष्णा
हरे कृष्णा एवरीवन। कृष्णा जय कृष्ण जय श्री कृष्णा। राइट होप एवरीवन हैड अ नाइस लॉन्ग वीकेंड। या गेटिंग बैक टू श्रीमद् भागवतम। हम लोग कैंटो 3 पढ़ रहे हैं चैप्टर 10 एंड श्लोक 26। या तो जैसा कि हम लोग काफी टाइम से पढ़ रहे हैं एक्चुअली फॉर फ्यू वीक्स नाउ। दिस इज द कन्वर्सेशन बिटवीन मैत्रेय मुनि एंड महात्मा विदुर। या सो मैत्रेय मुनि और महात्मा विदुर के बीच में कन्वर्सेशन हो रहा है। उस बीच में हमने देख लिया कि कैसे कॉस्मिक मैनिफेस्टेशन हुआ, कैसे ऑल द कंट्रोलिंग डेटीज केम, हाउ लॉर्ड ब्रह्मा जी गॉट मैनिफेस्टेड, हाउ लॉर्ड ब्रह्मा जी डिड प्रेयर्स टू लॉर्ड गोविंद। या एंड देन व्हाट वाज द रिस्पांस ऑफ लॉर्ड गोविंद टू लॉर्ड ब्रह्मा जी एंड देन सो वी हैव बीन सीइंग ऑल दिस एंड नाउ व्हाट इज बीइंग डिस्क्राइब्ड इज द 9 क्रिएशन। Right, so after all the natural creations, then there are 9 creations which are being described, and then we saw the first 6 creations, the additional creations, also happened from Lord Vishnu himself. Right, so we had Mahatattva. Yeah, for example, we said Mahatattva, the self ego, the mind, the knowledge, and the sense perception. Right, so those were like kind of the 6 ones, and then the remaining 3 were done by the creations of by Brahmaji, right? So we saw how the plants and trees and all those took place. Then we saw all the animals got generated, and then we were going to read the Navam, the 9th one, right? And the 9th one is the human being. So that's what we are reading currently, which is the 9th creation. So let's start the shlok, Anilji.
Yeah. अर्वाक् स्त्रोतस्तु नवम नवमः क्षत्रेक विधो नणाम रजोधिकाः कर्म परा दुखेच सुखमानिनः। द क्रिएशन ऑफ द ह्यूमन बीइंग्स हु आर ऑफ वन स्पेशीज ओनली एंड हु स्टार्ट द ईटेबल्स इन द बेली इज द 9th इन द रोटेशन इन द ह्यूमन रेस। The mode of passion is very prominent. Humans are always have in the midst of miserable life, but they think themselves happy in all respects. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, yeah. So this is mentioned about human beings, right? That's like us right now. Creation of human beings, yeah, is the 9th in rotation, as we have seen. The Navamaha Kshatreka Vidho Nirnan is the Manushya, right? And in us, what is more prominent, right, is the mode of passion. Mode of passion is the Rajogun. Yeah, it says Rajo Adhika Hai Karma Para. But the interesting thing which is mentioned here is humans are always busy in the midst of miserable life, right? Like as we know about ourselves, right? We are always busy doing something or something else or trying to look for happiness. Or even if it says even, but they think themselves happy in all respects. Yeah, we think, oh, we have achieved this, we have done this, we are always happy. But actually kind of a miserable life. Yeah. But that's what the Navam creation is. And let's read the purport, Suham.
The human being is endowed with a higher advanced stage of consciousness for getting relief from the existence of material miseries. But due to the ignorance, he thinks that his higher consciousness is meant for advancing in the material, converts of thus. Thus his intelligence misused the inner prosperities, eating, sleeping, defending, and mating, instead of spiritual in material comforts. The human being puts himself into a more miserable condition by the illusion by the material energy. He always thinks himself happy even while in the midst of misery. Such misery of human life is distinct from the natural, comfortable life enjoyed even by the animals. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, yeah. But the point which is being mentioned is the intelligence is being used in material acquisitions rather than the spiritual realization. Yeah. And that's what the important factor is. Yeah. Hare Krishna, Rasik Shyam Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna. कस्तु यह प्रोक्तः कौमारस्तु भयात्मकः. ट्रांसलेशन. ओ गुड विदुर. दिस लास्ट थ्री क्रिएशंस and the creation of demigod, the 10th creation, are Vakarta creations, which are different from the previously described prakata, natural creation. The appearance of Kumaras is both. Hare
Krishna. So Maitreya Muni bata rahe hai Mahatma Vidur ko, ki jo the last three creations which we saw, right, the animals and the plants, the human beings, and even the creations of demigods, right, which is seen as 10th creation, are Vaikrit creation. That is the one created by Lord Brahma. Yeah. Nisha?
Deva sargas chashta vidho vibhudaha pitaro asuraha gandharva अप्सरसः सिद्धा यक्षरस रसांसी चारणाः भूत प्रेत पिशाचाश्च विद्याद्राः किन्नरादयः दशैते विदुराख्याताः सर्गास्ते विश्व सृकृताः. The creation of the demigods is of 8 varieties. The demigods, the forefathers, the asuras or demons, the gandharvas and apsaras or angels, the yakas or rakshasas, the siddhas, karnas and vidyaras. And the bhutas, pretas, and pisach, and the superhuman beings, celestial singers, etc., all are created by the Brahma, the creator of the universe. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Yeah. Suhan?
Yeah. As explained in the second canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, the Siddhas or inhabitants of Siddhaloka were the residents traveling in space without vehicles. As their mere the will they can pass one planet to another without difficulty. Therefore, in the upper planets, the inhabitants are far superior to the inhabitants of this planet in all matters of art, culture, and science, since they possess the brain superior of those humans. Jin mentioned in this connection are also counted among the demigods because they're able to perform uncommon functions not possible for men. Hare Krishna.
Krishna, right? So as we can see, different levels, you know, different creations. Tarun?
Atha param pravakshyami vashanam navantarani cha evam rajap kulutit sprashta kalpadish vatma burhari सच्चते जते अमोघ संकल्प आत्मवत् मनम आत्मना. Translation. Now I shall describe the descendants of the Manus. The creator Brahma, as the incarnation of the passion mode of the personality of Godhead, creates the universal affairs with unfailing desires in every millennium by the force of the Lord's energy. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Yeah. So how the creation of the universe happens, yeah, and says the cosmic manifestation is an expansion of one of the many energies of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, yeah, by the external energy. As we see, the creator and the created are both emanations of the same Supreme Truth, right? The creator, the Lord Brahmaji, and the created, right, are born from the same Supreme Truth, as stated in the beginning of the Bhagavatam. Bhagavatam Janmadi Ashayatah. And the Bhaktivedanta purports of the third canto, 10th chapter of the Srimad Bhagavatam, entitled Divisions of the Creation. So, how we saw how the different divisions of the creation take place. Yeah. So, Srimad Bhagavatam ki. So we complete the 10th chapter and then we'll continue reading 11th. Yeah. All right, so chapter 11 is the calculation of time from the atom. Yeah, all about the science, I guess. So that's what we'll be reading, right? The atom, the parmanu, and how the calculation of the time takes place based on the atom activity. Yeah, so it'll be very interesting to read. So we'll continue reading the chapter 11. Ajay?
Sure. Maitreya Uvaj. Charmaha सशुद्ध शेष माला मनेको यम संयुतः सदा परमाणु सविज्ञो निर्णामैक्य भ्रतो गतः. Translation. The material manifestation's ultimate particle, which is indivisible and not formed into a body, is called the atom. It exists always as an invisible identity, even after the dissolution of all forms. The material body is stood by a common man. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Yeah. So if we read this, Tarun.
The atomic description of the Srimad Bhagavatam is almost the same as the modern science of atomism. And this is further described in the Paramanu Vada of Kannada. In modern science also, the atom is accepted as the ultimate indivisible particle of which the universe is composed. Srimad Bhagavatam is a full text of all descriptions of knowledge in atomism. Datam is the minute subtle form of eternal time. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, yeah. So, Srimad Bhagavatam is the full text of all descriptions of the knowledge. As we have been seeing, like, you know, in the Srimad Bhagavatam, you know, how including the cosmic manifestation, including manifestation of even, you know, all these elements of Vayu, Akash, Agni, everything is described, right? So that is the immense, the depth of knowledge which is there in Srimad Bhagavatam. And we have been seeing that, right? Hum log abhi tak sirf do canto pare hain, third is in progress. And we have seen so much knowledge has been there. And what is being mentioned is the atom is the minute shuttle form of eternal time. That's how atom is shown, right? As a shuttle form of eternal time, Kal. Yeah. Rinaj?
Sat eva padarthasya swarupavasthitasya yat kaivalyam param mahan visheshu nirantarah. Atoms are the ultimate state of the manifest universe. When they stay in their own form without forming different bodies, they are called the unlimited oneness. There are certainly different bodies in physical forms, but the atoms themselves form the complete manifestation. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Yeah, so that's how the atoms are being described. Sumit there, so?
No, yes, I have a phone call. Okay. Attend.
Okay, that's fine. Okay, Ajay? Ajay, do it. Can you hear Ajay? Okay, Nisha? Okay.